When the ATAC trial was reported in 2005 that indicated that the aromatase inhibitors were slightly better than tamoxifen in postmenopausal women, the time that they picked to give the aromatase inhibitors was, like tamoxifen, for 5 years. When they got to 5 years, the question came up, would there be benefit to more than 5 years of an aromatase inhibitor? And there was a national trial that was closed about a year ago where patients who had been on an aromatase inhibitor for 5 years were randomized to either receive no more aromatase inhibitor or to receive another 5 years of aromatase inhibitor, obviously wanting to answer the question, would 10 years of therapy be better than five? Needless to say, we won't have an answer to this for at least another 4 or 5 years. My own practice is that if a patient has a particularly aggressive breast cancer, such as a very large breast cancer, or especially a breast cancer with multiple positive nodes, I would tend to continue the aromatase inhibitor for a second 5 years if the patient's doing well with it and her bone density is reasonable. If, however, she has a very early stage breast cancer, I don't see any need to continue the aromatase inhibitor beyond 5 years.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.